Good morning, everyone. I'm very glad to introduce this conference and to bring you the regards of the rector of the University of Milan Bicocca as her delegate for sustainability and as president of the degree course in tourism sciences. As you know, Italy is among the countries most affected by the coronavirus COVID-19, in particular in its northern and central regions. Since the epidemic appeared in our country, 176,000 people have been infected, and unfortunately, 24,000 people have died. As I know, most people over 65 died. Although the beginning concentrated in the regions of northern Italy, especially in Lombardy, the virus spread quickly throughout Italy. The videos show the spreading speed of the virus in Italy and in the Lombardy. Lombardy is the first region struck by the virus. The problem is that Lombardy is the most industrialized region in Italy, which contributes for more than a fifth of the gross domestic product. Over the 9 months before the crisis, the Lombard exchange with China was over 13 billion out of the total of 34 billion. The import alone is worth about 10 billion out of the 24 national, the 41%, and the export 3 billion out of 9, the 33%. The consequences of the crisis on the Italian economy will be very strong, although with a different intensity according to the various scenarios, basic or pessimistic. In both scenarios, hotels, travel agencies, tour operators, accommodations, and air transport will record the worst performances. According to many sources, tourism, travel, airlines, and retail will be the sectors most hit by the crisis on both liquidity and profitability. In 2020 coronavirus emergency, could burn 18 billion of tourist spending, 9.2 billion for the decrease in incoming, and 8.8 billion for the cancellation of holidays in Italy by the Italian people. The drop in total consumption of goods and services would be a consequence of the fall of 29 million arrivals, which in turn would generate 143 million fewer presences, with a decrease of 22 and 34% rispectively compared to 2019. According to a survey carried out by the Demoscopica Institute on the 11th March, on a representative sample of over 1,000 Italians, at least 14 million citizens would have already decided not to go on a holiday in July and in August. The incidence of the level of the reduction of tourist spending is expected to be very high in the region of Veneto, Lombardy, Tuscany, and Lazio, some of the most touristic regions in Italy. The most important causes that will generate a decline in the total volumes of the Italian foreign demand are expected to be the following. The first one, the vacation amount reduction. Secondly, the long-haul travel risk increase. And thirdly, the spending power reduction. The further is on the booking window decrease. Five, the weakening of the brokerage system. Six, information on the resurgence of the epidemic. And and the last one, the contraction of the offer. With attention to the hotel sector in overall, a drop in demand is estimated between 45% and 55%, depending on the evolution and the duration of the lockdown measures. The estimates reported for the scenarios aforementioned would bring the Italian hotel system up to the level of the late 17. It's estimated a total loss of presences included between 126 million and 153 million compared to the average hotel volumes expected by 2020. The figure describes the trend of the Italian foreign hotel demand in different scenarios related to three lockdown end dates, the 15th of April, the 30th of April, and the 15th of May. To conclude, the crisis caused by the coronavirus will certainly have very serious and negative consequences on the Italian economy and tourism. To face it, it will be necessary to design suitable scenarios to predict the effects in the different market and tourism sectors. However, as we have seen throughout the outbreak, not all countries have been affected in the same way. Those that have been most efficient in predicting the outbreak and its containment are the same ones that have been able to better cope with the crisis. We are in the specific phase in which accurate forecast must be proposed in order to activate resources, especially local ones, in order to contain the negative effects of the crisis. Thank you very much for your attention.